Hello 7th class, I am Dipendra Singh, your mathematics teacher, and today we are going to discuss all the properties of integers, right? On the basic operation, multiplication, division, subtraction and addition. In reverse we can say addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we are going to see all the properties for all these basic operations. So I am going to tell you in the summarized way, right? So for addition, I'll check all the property. For subtraction, I'll check all the property. For multiplication, I'll check all the property. And for the division also, I'll check all the property. So I have written over here short form only because we are going to discuss all the property for each and every basic operation. So basically, how many type of property are there, that we are going to see first. So first is commutative property. Commutative property. And the second one is associative property. Associative property. Then third one is identity property. Identity property, right? So these three major properties are there that we are going to discuss for each and every operation. So first of all, I'll see for the addition. For the addition, I'll see each and every rule, every property. Okay, so in addition, if I talk about commutative property, so basically the meaning of commutative is if you reversing any number over the operation addition, so it will not change the value, right? So we are going to see according to commutative property for the addition, if a plus b, whatever it will come, it must be equal to b plus a. This is LHS and this is RHS, and if they both are equal, it means commutative property is valid for addition. So we are going to see by the example. So let's see one example. A is equal to 5 and B I am going to take 3, right? So we are going to check now LHS. So LHS is nothing but A plus B. So A plus B, 5 plus 3, it will come 8 only, right? Because in the whole board we are going to discuss right now for addition only. So don't worry that I am writing in the front of subtraction or multiplication division. For reference, I have written over here subtraction, multiplication and division. So first of all, we are going to see all the things for the addition only. I hope you are getting it. Okay, so 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. Now we are going to check RHS. So RHS is basically B plus A, means 3 plus 5. Again, it is coming in. So both are equal. It means addition is following commutative property. Right? Addition is following commutative property. So now we are going to see associate property. So associate property, according to associate property, A plus B plus C, it must be equal A plus B in one bracket and plus C. Here basically we are associating B with different value. First time we have associated B with C, second time we have associated B with A, right? So that is why it is called associative property. So we are going to check for the addition. That is why everywhere I put the plus sign, plus, 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 plus. So students, we are going to check associative property for the addition, whether it is correct or not. So this is associative property, but we have to check whether it is correct or not. So we are going to take one example. A, I am going to take 5, B, I am going to take 3, and C, I am going to take 2. I used to take these three numbers because these three numbers are my favorite number. Right, so LHS we are going to calculate first. What is LHS? LHS is nothing but A plus B plus C. Now we are going to put the value, right? We are going to put the value. Okay, in the place of A, 5, plus in the place of B, 3, plus C, 2. So it will come 5 plus 3 plus 2, 5. It will come 10. Okay, so now we are going to solve RHS. Because by that only we will tell that whether LHS is equal to RHS or not. So what is RHS? RHS is nothing but A plus B plus C. Again we are going to put the value. What is the value of A? We considered as example. It's an example that we are seeing. right? And by example only we are verifying that addition is following associative property or not. So 5 plus 3 plus 2, 5 plus 3, 8, a plus 2 will come 10. So it is also coming 10, it is also coming 10. It means addition is following associative property, right? Hence verified. We had verified by the example, right? So why it is called associative property? I told you, means the same number, that is B. First time I have associated B with C, and second time I associated B with A. And we will always solve the bracket first. So first we have solved the bracket 5, and then 5 plus 5, 10. Here basically, first we have to solve the bracket A plus B, right? So 5 plus 3 will come 8, and then A plus 2 will come 10. So they both are equal. It means addition is following associative property. Now we are going to see for identity property. Okay, so first of all, I want to tell you, identity property is not the property to check on something, right? Identity property, that property that by which number I'll add to any number so that number will not change. This is the simple meaning of identity property. So it's not the property to check on something. Is the property to tell on something, that by which number I'll add on a given number so that it will not change. So we know that if I'll add any number 0, so it will not change. Again, it will come A only. So basically 0 is additive identity for the addition. Means if I'll add 0 to any number, the number will never change. So I hope you are getting the identity property of addition. Okay, so basically we have done addition part, right? So I am going to erase these all. So for the addition, commutative property is following, associative property following, identity property. So for identity property, what is additive identity for the addition? That is 0. So now we are going to see for the subtraction, all the property we are going to check one by one. If I talk about commutative, commutative is simply so in the addition that we have to change the sequence and we have to check whether they are coming equal or not. So for the subtraction we are going to check also. Now all the property we are going to check for the subtraction. Now I'm going to fill all the board for the subtraction only, right? Now this thing is on. Okay, let's see commutative property. So in commutative property, I told you have to change the sequence and you have to check whether they are coming equal or not. It means if A minus B, we calculate, it must be equal to B minus A according to commutative property. And if it is not coming equal, it means subtraction is not following commutative property. But that we have to check through the example. So I am going to take A as 5 and I am going to take B as 3. I told you these are my favorite number. Okay, so let's see LHS. So LHS is nothing but A minus B. So we'll put the value of A, that is 5. What is the value of B? That is 3, and it will come 2. Let's solve RHS. It's very simple calculation, na? But you must understand property, commutative property means if I change the sequence, it must be equal. Okay, B minus A means 3 minus 5, right? And 3 minus 5, we know that it will come 2 only, but 5 is a greater number having negative sign. So it will come minus only. Oh no, they are not coming equal. If they are not coming equal, it means subtraction is not following commutative property. Okay, from here it is very clear that commutative property, is not applicable on subtraction. Means A minus B is not coming equal B minus A, right? We started checking on, and then in final it is not coming equal, right? Okay, now we are going to see associative property for the subtraction. So again we will write the statement same as we were writing before. Means A minus B minus C, I am associating B with C this time, and in that side I am associating B with A. This is the association, means in bracket, in one bracket you have to keep that number, and then minus C. So we are going to check that whether they are equal or not, and if they are not equal, it means for the subtraction associative property is not getting followed. Okay, so let's see by the example. So I'm going to take A as 5, B as 3, C as 2, my favorite numbers, 5, 3, 2. Okay, so now we are going to see LHS. LHS is nothing but A minus B and B minus C. We are going to put the value. What is the value of A? 5 minus 3 minus 2. We know by the board mass, we are going to solve the bracket first. So 5 minus 3 minus 2. What it will come? It will come 1 only, right? And it will come 4. 4 we have calculated as, you know, LHS. Now we are going to see RHS. So if I talk about RHS, so RHS is nothing but A minus B in one bracket and minus C, right? And we are going to put the value, because in example we have already considered these three value A, B, C. 5, 3, 2, we are going to put the value. So 5 minus 3 and then minus 2. So 5 minus 3 will come, because we are going to solve the bracket first according to board mass rule. So this is the bracket, that bracket we are going to solve first. So if I solve the bracket, 5 minus 3, it will come 2, and 2 minus 2, it will come 0. Oh no, they are again not coming equal. LHS we have calculated as 4 and RHS we have calculated as 0, right? And they are not coming equal. If they are not coming equal, it means, what does it mean? It simply means that subtraction, because all the things we are discussing right now for the subtraction. So subtraction is not following associative property, right? It's very simple. Okay. So it means A minus B, B minus C is not equal to A minus B in one bracket minus C. It is not equal. Before that we were checking, and finally you found that they both sides are not equal. Again we are going to see identity property. So I told you in the addition also, this is not the property to check, it is the property to tell that what is subtractive identity. What is subtractive identity means what is that number by which if I subtract to any number, so that number will not change. So that number is again basically zero, right? Means if I take any number and by that number if I subtract zero, so it will come always same. So what is subtractive identity for any number? That is zero. So overall subtraction is not following commutative property and associative property, right? And I told you for the identity property, what is subtractive identity for any number? That is zero. I hope you are getting